हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी माइकल पोर्टर्स वैल्यू चेन एनालिसिस इन डिटेल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज वैल्यू चेन एनालिसिस। अ वैल्यू चेन इज अ सेट ऑफ एक्टिविटीज दैट एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अंडरटेक्स टू क्रिएट वैल्यू फॉर इट्स कस्टमर्स। सो हाउ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन क्रिएट्स वैल्यू? मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनीज क्रिएट वैल्यू बाय एक्वायरिंग रॉ मटेरियल एंड यूजिंग देम टू प्रोड्यूस समथिंग यूजफुल। Retailers bring together a range of products and offer them in a convenient way to customers, sometimes supported by services such as fitting rooms or personal shopper advice. The more value an organization creates, the more profitable it is likely to be. Michael Porter discussed this in his book Competitive Advantage, in which he introduced the concept of the value chain for the first time. Following points we are covered in Michael Porter's value chain approach. Please watch my video till end because you will find different examples for each and every point we are going to study today. Category A, primary activity. Primary activities are those activities that are involved in the creation of a product or service. Porter has classified these primary activities into five groups: inbound logistic, operations, outbound logistics, marketing and sales, and services. Point number one, inbound logistic. Inbound logistic is where purchased input such as raw material are often taken care of. Due to this function, it is also in contact with external companies such as suppliers. Activities associated with inbound logistics are receiving, storing, and disseminating input to the product. For example, inbound logistics for Starbucks refers to selecting the finest quality of coffee beans by the company's appointed coffee buyers from coffee producers in Latin America, Africa, and Asia. In the case of Starbucks, the green and unroasted beans are procured directly from the farms by the Starbucks buyers. Point number two, operation. Operation include all activities through which inputs are turned into outputs that an organization sells. Operation activity include manufacturing, assembling, testing, packaging, etc. For example, Nike. Nike is present globally and each of its offices caters to large geographic area of many countries. There are more than 500 factories producing Nike product in 42 countries. Point number three, outbound logistic. Outbound logistic are related to finished output which are in sellable form. After the final product is produced, it still needs to find its way to the customer. Various activities related to outbound logistics are finished goods warehousing, material handling, preparing delivery schedule, physical distribution, etc. For example, Amazon.com. The e-commerce giants operates 109 fulfillment centers worldwide and the company use robotic technology in a comprehensive way to manage receipt, picking, and shipment of product. Point number four, marketing and sales. Marketing and selling involve motivating the buyer to buy the products and incorporating their intention to buy into the actual sale. The various activities covered in this category are advertising and sales promotion, channel selection, creating a sales force, pricing, etc. Coca-Cola implements integrated marketing strategy using advertising, sales promotions, event and experiences, and public relations element of the marketing mix in a combined way. The brand marketing message is associated with being happy, enjoying life, and leading an active lifestyle. Point number five, services. In today's economy, after-sale services is as important as promotional activities. Complaints from unsatisfied customers are easily spread and shared due to the internet, and the consequences on your company's reputation might be vast. Therefore, it is important to have the right customer service practices. Activities associated with this part of the value chain are providing service to enhance and maintain the value of the product after it has been sold and distributed. Some activities involved in these categories are installation, repair, training, etc. For example, Airtel said that it has set itself the goal of answering and resolving every single customer query, learn quickly from failure and make sure they are not repeated. Category B, support activities. Support activities are those that provide support for the effective performance of primary activities in the value chain. The support activities can therefore be divided into procurement, technology development, human resource management, and firm infrastructure. Number 1. Procurement. Procurement involves obtaining purchased input, whether raw materials, services, machinery, etc. Procurement activities stretch across the entire value chain because they support each activity. Procurement activities can be centralized in an organization or group based on the similarity of purchased input and performed by different personnel. For example, Starbucks handles all the procurement for its own coffee bean, which it sees as one of its competitive advantages. Number 2. Technology development. It pertains to the equipment, hardware, software, procedure and technical knowledge brought to bear in the firm's transformation of inputs into outputs. The level of technology development determines an organization's efficiency. Technology development activities can be grouped into effort to improve the product and the process. For example, artificial intelligence. Netflix uses the watching history of users with similar tastes to recommend what user may be most interested in watching next, so that users stay engaged and continue your monthly subscription for more. Point number 3. Human resource management. Human resource management covers all processes and systems involved in employee management, like attendance, payroll, paid time off, and recruitment of employees. Human resource management is most important for service-oriented businesses, where the customer experience rests on the shoulders of skilled employees. For example, at Google, employees are considered the company's most valuable asset. They are given freedom, a healthy work-life balance, incredible perks, and even the chance to have fun at work. Point number 4. Firm infrastructure. Without a proper infrastructure, a firm might face a big hurdle. Firm infrastructure involves activities such as general management, accounting, finance, legal, planning, etc. that creates values for organization. For example, Apple is investing hugely in development of the company's infrastructure to ensure that they have the best infrastructure. Friends, thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, then please subscribe to my channel Management by Dr. Mitul Dhimmer and share my videos. Thank you.